الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهدي ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. I greet everyone with the most beautiful greeting, the greeting of Islam as well as the greeting of Jannah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah. We thank and praise Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, who once again afford us an opportunity of Jumu'ah, a Jumu'ah of change. We've heard the change in the greeting. Everybody probably had a nice breakfast this morning. Allah bless those who had the breakfast. Allah bless those who are fasting today as well. But we start off by saying, I hope everybody had a wonderful Eid yesterday. An Eid which is accepted by Allah ta'ala, as we celebrated, mashallah, a month that has gone by so quickly. But alhamdulillah, we've maximized on improving ourselves as human beings, improving ourselves as Muslims. What we have achieved, inshallah, may Allah ta'ala allow us to keep up with the pace that we have set for ourselves. Because indeed, what we found in Ramadan is, this is who I am. I'm able to cope with this. I'm able to read one khatam. I'm able to read two khatams a month. I'm able to read three khatams a month. I'm able to read, inshallah, four khatams or five khatams a month. Allah Ta'ala knows best who we are and how much effort we placed in. And how much time we utilized, understanding that when Allah Ta'ala gives us good times, that we throw ourselves broken in front of Allah Ta'ala, utilizing that and maximizing that time in order to gain maximum benefit, inshallah. Similarly today, we should not think that today is anything less, because Friday is an Eid of a believer. It's again Eid for us. Allah gave us two Eids after each other. Thursday Eid, Friday Eid, mashallah. The Eid of the week. And this is also a day that we should celebrate. Why? This is once a week that we gather like this, showing our unity, standing together, line by line, shoulder to shoulder. أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى. Worshipping Allah as we see Him جل جلاله, as if we see Him جل جلاله. And this is the ultimate goal of a believer. It's إحسان. For indeed, هل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان. And what can the reward for good be except good? And may Allah grant us a good reward for all our efforts. آمين يا رب العالمين. جماعة المسلمين, always when we finish with Ramadan, we reflect. And this is the life of a believer. حاسبوا قبل أن تحاسبوا. They take stock of yourself before stock will be taken for you or from you. So we are taking stock. And we know that if we take stock, we try and see, mashallah, I've actually done exceptionally well during the month of Ramadan. But we all know ourselves. After Ramadan is not that easy. Fasting in Ramadan is, I think it's the easiest fast. Why is it the easiest fast? Because Allah Ta'ala commands us to fast. It's a commandment from Allah Ta'ala and we cannot escape it. Except if we fell ill, except if we are traveling, then there's certain rukhas, certain reasons and certain beautiful gifts that Allah Ta'ala gives us. Then, subhanAllah, we are allowed to break our fast and pay in those fasts again after Ramadan. But inevitably, what is meant here is Allah Ta'ala instructs us to fast. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ بِمَعْنَى فُرِضَ عَلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامِ. Allah Ta'ala has made it incumbent upon the believers. You have to fast during the month of Ramadan. So that's very easy for us. Why? We're executing Allah Ta'ala's law and we will try our utmost best not to violate that law. But after Ramadan, it is not that easy, because now it's not an instruction and a command from Allah Ta'ala. It is an added bonus for us. Now Allah Ta'ala look at us to improve ourselves in the rewards and raise ourselves in rank. You know, we do this now not because Allah instructs us. We do this now out of love for Allah Ta'ala and His Rasul. Fasting, commandment. Fard fasting. Sunnah fasting out of hubb and love for Allah Ta'ala. Nobody's going to wake up just one day and say, okay, I'm going to fast. You're going to fast because you want the rewards for fasting. You want Allah Ta'ala to reward you for this fast. You want to be of those who man ahabba sunnati ahabbani, that who loves my sunnah love me. We love the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Why? Because he fasted on a Monday. Why? Because he fasted on a Thursday. Why? Because he fasted on the 13th, 14th and 15th of every month. Why? Because he fasted on the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. Why? Because he fasted on the 10th of Muharram, or the 9th and the 10th of Muharram, or the 10th and the 11th of Muharram. Some of the people, because of the awe of the moment of Mi'raj, people feel that they want to fast on that day. That is out of hubb and love for Allah and His Rasul. The Nisfi Sha'ban, some people feel that they want to fast on that day out of love and hubb for His Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we do actions out of love. Extra actions is out of love for Him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and out of love for Allah Ta'ala. We want to gain closeness to them, Jalla Jalalu. So that is a challenge for us. So all of us heard what I said. We fast Monday and Thursday. Why? Out of love. Does this mean that those who doesn't fast on a Monday and a Thursday does not love Allah and His Rasul? No, indeed it doesn't mean that. Because then I'm going to be the first one, because yes, salam. Very difficult for me to fast on a Monday and a Thursday and the 13th, 14th and 15th of every month. Astaghfirullah, shouldn't be difficult. But to some, it's not that easy. But does it then mean that that person doesn't love the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Oh, I'm going to say, because I'm fasting on a Monday and a Thursday, and because I'm fasting on the 13th, 14th and the 15th, I'm better than the one that don't fast. Is this the attitude of a believer? Allahu Akbar. That one person can do one action of good. And let's mention the words of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. What he says about actions of good, he says that لا تحكرن من المعروف شيئا, that don't take any small action in the eyes of Allah as being insignificant and unnoticed. Any action. He's not mentioning the biggest of actions. He's not mentioning salah in specific. How much salah you make and how much salah the other one make. No. How much fasting. No. لا تحكرن من المعروف شيئا. Any action. Just moving a stone out of the road for somebody else with the intention, Ya Allah, I don't want my brother or my sister or any human being or anyone to get hurt, because I'm just removing a stone from the path where other people are walking. That's an action of khair and good intention. Everything goes within that. You are not just going to move a stone out of the road. The reason that we are going to move a stone out of the road is because there's a reason for it. Hey, somebody can get hurt. A banana peel is laying there. What are you going to do? You're going to pick up the banana peel, you throw it in the bin. That's an action of good, but there's an intention behind it. Somebody can get hurt. لا تحكرن من المعروف شيئا. Don't take these actions of small that you're doing as being insignificant in the eyes of Allah. ولو أنت الأخاك. Even if it is that you meet your brother بوجه طريق, with a joyous and happy face. Like Maulana Wasim. MashaAllah. May Allah bless you. Ameen. We should always try to have a smile on our face. The easiest way to receive charity. Because today's world, it's difficult, man. We want to walk like morbid guys around. Because it's either things are difficult, or, you know, the morbid face today represent what? The O face. The more bristled you walk, you know, the arms, mashallah, you know who I am. I don't even know who I am myself, Ya Rab. You know, this is who I am, but this is who I am. Look at me. I'm flying. Look at my coat. There's no wind, but it's ma, Ya Rab. Allahu Akbar. You know, this is, subhanAllah. You know, this is not the explanation for this. We should not. Smiling is amazing. Smiling is contagious, like they say. Wallah, it's contagious. I witness it every day in my life. Sometimes, you know, we have a bad day. But just, you know, you stretch that muscle just a little bit. Mashallah, the day becomes a malikam. I come to the masjid and this is the best place. Wallah, you can practice it. Go to your work, see that morbid guy that walk with a coat that no wind and all that. Yes, I'm here again, subhanAllah, and I must force myself to smile. It's a fake smile. We all know that, right? We have people that we meet, but okay, assalamu alaikum, ajeeb. Right, mashallah, Allah, forgive me, but not this guy. You know, we have that within us as well. I can see everybody's happy, Ramadan is done, I'm again back to my old self, joke is there, mashallah, right? But there's a message behind it, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah accept, ameen, ameen. You know, so when we're there, we are pretending. And pretending is not good. Even if that guy is like that. Remember the words of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. لا تحكرن من المعروف شيئا. He is that guy that makes it difficult. But I'm going to be the guy that makes it easy for him. I'm changing the tides. He makes everybody shakes in the working place. I make everybody smile in the working place. Allahu Akbar. This is who we should be. A Muslim bring joy to everybody else. People see the beauty even in a smile of a believer. This is Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's way. Can you imagine when him, can you just imagine, there's the door. You close your eyes. And just imagine we are living in the time of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he enters, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Can you imagine what the atmosphere will be here? We would be silent and quiet. And we will just look at him in awe. Some of us will be able to look at his face because of how much we love him. Some of us will be too shy. We look down. But just being in his presence, it will just be an amazing feeling. That is our Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Wallahi, that was every time that he entered into a khadab, into a jama'ah of people that gather, that is exactly how they felt. He brought light to a community. He brought light to Yathrib. Yathrib, today Madinatul Munawwara. Yathrib was a place of sickness and illness where no trader wanted to base himself, not even for a day. They come just quickly and poof, gone are they. Because this is a place where it's too much illness and sickness and badness that we get from this place. And upon entry of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam into that time known as Yathrib, suddenly it became the illuminated city of Madinatul Munawwara. This the effect that one human being could have on an entire city. That is not the truth. That one human being could have on an entire ummah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we hear his name, it makes us happy. Inshallah, it must be like that. Ameen. Now, that's why important, practice his sunnah. Because if you practice his sunnah, you create a love for him, whether you know about, you know it or not, it's going to happen. Just practice his sunnah. Somebody that every day, can you imagine? Every day he takes time out. He says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Ya Rabbi salli alayhi wa sallim. Allahumma. He takes time out just for that. Sending salutations upon him. That cannot just be, okay, I'm just sending salutations upon you. That is a relationship that you develop with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's meaning to that salawat. This individual that I'm sending the salutations upon, this is the individual that's the most beloved to Allah. And in my life, he must be the most beloved to me. So that's why I send abundance of salutations upon him. Whether you know it or not, and the scholars, they mention, if it is that you feel in your heart, I feel nothing. You know, when I say Allahumma salli ala, astaghfirullah, may Allah protect us and forgive us. But if it is that you feel nothing when you say Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, the scholars say, still say it. Say it a lot. Because definitely that salawat will have an effect on you. It will have an effect on you. No matter if you like it or if you don't. I remember some people used to tell me, why is it that you praise the Prophet so much? Ya astaghfirullah. You know, it seems like you're worshipping and you put him on a higher pedestal than Allah. People don't understand. You speak about Muhammad, your intention is Allah. Man. You coming out by Allah. Because Allah loves him and Allah is instructing you that you must send salutations upon him. Why? Because Allah sends salutations upon him. Allah Ta'ala says, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Perpetually Allah and his malaika send salutations upon Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Every moment, you can't blink an eye that salutations are not sent upon Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So your and my salutations is not needed. You know, Allah don't need you to send salutations. Allah sends salutations upon him. But Allah says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, then Allah gives a command. Can you imagine this? Allah could have just said, okay, and please send. But Allah say, you must. Because I send, and my malaika send. Allah say, sallu. You must send salutations. Alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I command this from Allah Ta'ala to send salutations. It hurts your heart when you think that a Muslim can tell you. Why must you praise it? Almost like the people of the Christians. They praise Jesus so much. Yeah, Allah, you equate a Muslim to a Christian. You equate a Muslim to somebody that is not a Muslim? No, No, Jamaatul Muslimin. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. Allah gives you honor. Why you take the honor away from you? Allah gives us honor. Allah gives us, you and me, Allah give us honor. We want to snatch that honor away from ourselves and the dignity and that high rank that Allah give us as people? No, we receive that. We embrace that. That is us. And we have work to do. We have a lot of work to do. And that's why Ramadan came to teach us who we are. Every opportunity that we had, we were kind. We were kind and our kindness paid off. MashaAllah, assalamu alaikum. Our kindness paid off. Astaghfirullah, we don't speak. Okay, let me see. How many people has met people during the month of Ramadan? And because of the kindness, people gave their hand and said, I want to be a Muslim. How many people? Wallahi, I've witnessed it myself. I'm not going to say who was the one that gave the da'wah and who was the one that, you know, because we are nothing but a means and a tool that Allah uses. It's not us. It's Allah who gives hidayah. Allah gives hidayah. But why? Why? Can you just imagine that Allah used you as a means? But you want to walk around more, but the people speak to you. You give them abrupt answers. And then you expect the people to see the beauty of Islam. Never you chasing people far away from the way of truth. Be kind. Yusuf Sallam says, Bu'ithtu li utammima makarim al-akhlaq. What I came, my best gift that Allah has given me. Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. It's my character. Follow this part of mine. I love this character. Adab, fawqal ilm. You can have all the knowledge in the world, but your adab will outshine that knowledge. You have a lot of people that are not knowledgeable, but we kind of just attach ourselves to them. We love them. We just want to be in their company. Why? It's not because of the knowledge. It's because of the aura. It's just because they make you happy when you're there. You don't need people to have, mashallah, we must indulge in company where there's scholars and sadiqeen, you know, and alims and ulama. This is good gatherings. But imagine a gathering, you know, the alim sit in front. You know, we make an example of an alim. He is so morbid, he is so rude. But he's teaching you the kalam. Who's going to sit in his class? You say, no man, this guy is on baskof, man. He has no way to talk to me. I'm asking him a question and he just abruptly just chased me away and just shunned me like this. You're not going to find joy in that. So you're going to move to somewhere else where you're going to find that, okay, now this is a guy that I can approach. This is a guy that I can love. This is a guy that I can take my deen from, subhanAllah. You know, mashallah, he's got good qualities. He reminds me of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is amazing. And that is what scholars must learn. Adopt the character of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in everything. You know, I'm speaking about the ulama. Who was the ulama of the past? Ya Allah, they had so much respect for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They had so much respect for the deen. They would sit in a certain manner. They would take care of that kitab, that book. It will be perfumed. When they recite it, they will recite it in a beautiful, you know, mashallah, you hear. I love to just listen to the clips of my honorable teacher, Mufti Mawlana Muhammad Ta'a Karan, when he used to read the hadith, you know, he used to have a certain tune to it when he read it. You can see the joy on his face when he read it. You know, Allah, you sit there, you're not only enjoying the reading of the words, but you enjoy the reading of the sound. You're enjoying the reading of the person that sits in front of you because you know, subhanAllah, this is a person that is close to Allah Ta'ala. You can see it, you can feel it, you love being in the presence. This is ajeeb. This is what it is, our pious predecessors. When they used to teach, they were... Allah, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, who was he? A person came to him with an amount of questions, and he was the most knowledgeable of his time. Ahmad ibn Hanbal. What happened? And when they came in his company, they had these questions and they asked him, and I think he only answered like plus minus three questions and all the other questions. I said, but you are Ahmad ibn Hanbal. I've been sent from so far to come and ask you these questions. All you say is, la adri, la adri, la adri. No, you must answer me. So what was his answer? You tell the person that sent you that Ahmad ibn Hanbal said it, I don't know. I don't know the answer. What do you want me to tell you? The humility of the scholars and the genuineness of the scholars, they were truthful. Today we want to answer every... You don't even ask an alim. You ask just the guy that loves Google. You know, mashallah, he speaks so well. He just loves Google. He quotes Google also. And you believe him quoting Google. And you're like, oh, nah, what? He will put that Maulana in a chips pucky, man. This guy's got knowledge. Yeah. You will find those times also where those, subhanAllah, that lead people astray, they will be the leaders. And Allah protect us from that. They never ever sat at the feet of no alim. They never qualified in one book. But they are the ones that give the fatawa today. Allah protect us. Jamaatul Muslimin, our honor and our dignity of Islam is very important. We have a legacy of isnad, a legacy of sanad. That my studies, I took from somebody who studied, who took from somebody who studied, and they all have ijazat, and it linked to the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's important. Be careful who you take your deen from. Wallahi, be careful. Jamaatul Muslimin, easy to go astray. If the Google will teach you many things, and you might, it might be a proper alim that's also speaking there, but your understanding of it might be wrong. So go to the alim and say, do I understand this properly? Because I don't want to practice something, because I'm going to start this practice. And then my children, and their children, and people that are connected to them will practice this practice. And I will lay in my qabr and I will get a beating of my life every single day. Why? Because I started the practice. Ay sunnah sayyi'ah. Man sanna sunnatan hasana. There's good in that, yes. Starting and reviving a sunnah that's good, there's good reward. But sayyi'ah, a sunnah that's totally not part of sharia, that because I felt that I have the knowledge, I wanted to start practicing. That is a big problem. You can start getting hiding in the qabr and you're not even going to know what you did because your intention was good, but the ego told me I know more. The eloquence of this guy's English is better than the eloquence of that alim's English. Wallahi, deen is not based on English. If deen was based on English, everybody would have been ulama. But that's why Allah made it, that you must go and sit. You must go and sit nights. The one who burns the midnight oil is the one that will benefit. You need to sit up nights. Allahu Akbar, sitting with books. If I think about it, it gives me goosebumps. I love it, alhamdulillah. I enjoy it. But some people, yes, you know, when the ulama sit for 8 months, 9 months, 10 months sometimes with one mas'ala, people don't know that. To get to an answer takes effort. It takes 20, 30, 40, 50 books, long readings to get to a judgment. Because that alim don't want to make the mistake and say, no. You know, I found the first answer and this is the answer. That's why the most beloved answer to Ali radiallahu ta'ala was what? I don't know. Who? The faqih al-umma, the door of knowledge. Babul ilm. Ali, karramallahu wajha. His favorite answer, I don't know. Just hold on. Let me first make sure, brother, whether I'm Ali or not, this doesn't work. This is not my deen. This is Allah's deen. May Allah ta'ala guide us. In Ramadan, we've achieved how to? The tongue. Control it. Actions, control it. Be kind. Oh, mashallah, I have little. Bismillah. Good art. And we saw the results almost instantaneously. Wallahi, I believe this Ramadan was a whole miracle. My whole life in Ramadan was a miracle. Because I don't have. Okay, you mustn't say you have. You say alhamdulillah for what you have. But I mean, for us terms to understand, we don't have much. But we give. And uqsimu billah, I'm in Jummah. My tears want to start rolling because ya Allah, you are the greatest being, man. And you prove it to us all the time. As we give, you see, ya salam. There it comes. And you give it. Oh, there it comes again. You're like instantaneously, ya Rab. And you give it. Oh, there's it again. You know, if you are people that are conscious of Allah Ta'ala, will see the bounty. You won't just give and give and give, and then afterwards you want to say, ya Allah, what do you give? Every day you see what Allah gives you. Ajib, we see. Till today, wallahi, till today we give and we saw Allah's mercy. Ya salam, there's it again. Allah Ta'ala just give us. And sometimes we think the giving is just a monetary. It's not just a monetary thing. I didn't feel so well this morning. And mashallah, the radio decided they want, mashallah, you must be on now. Voice, ya. I said, oh Allah. Yeah, I'm in a tough task here, you know, but okay, let's go for this. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I spoke on the radio. It was like the most easiest radio station program that I've presented. I don't know how many years. Just flowing, alhamdulillah. Prepared for it. There we go. And on top of that, I thought, yo, die mond, bis jy droog nou baie gepraat, ne? Hele uur, en ek weer kom praat hier in Juma. Subhanallah, wallah, I'm speaking to you and I just loved what I'm doing because I love you. For the sake of Allah Ta'ala, and we love what we are doing. May Allah Ta'ala accept from us, inshallah. So my time is up, but the message today is, be who you found yourself to be in Ramadan. Every action that you have practiced, try to maintain it. And inshallah, we know we've done a lot in Ramadan. Don't try to do the lot that you have done in Ramadan now for the whole year. Try to choose like three of the good things that you, for example, Quran recital, Salah on time, and fasting on a Monday and a Thursday, or only a Monday, or only a Thursday. That's good. Just those three things, inshallah ta'ala, implement that in your life, right? Why? Because the actions that Allah ahabba, the actions that are most beloved to Allah ta'ala is what? Adwamuha. Is that what that we do regularly? Wa in qalla, even if it is small or little. That little that you took from Ramadan, inshallah, that will shape your character, that will shape your demeanor, that will shape your personality. Next year Ramadan, we can add on to that, inshallah. We can do better. Now you say, Ya Rab, I've got the three behind me now. Now, inshallah, I want to go to the next three. I want to implement that in my life now for another year, inshallah. And then I go, and that is how the one Ramadan can just be better than the first, the previous Ramadan, and the next Ramadan can be better than the previous Ramadan. And then you can feel that sense of acceptance from Allah Ta'ala. But the sign of acceptance for us, as we know ourselves, is if we can keep up with what we have done in Ramadan, not all of it, but at least shape our life accordingly, mashallah. I can still recite my Quran daily. I can still perform my 5 times salah on time. Mashallah, I think I've achieved something. Ya Allah, accept it from me. Ya Allah, keep me steadfast on this path that I cannot never ever leave this again. And inshallah, let me topple up next year, inshallah, with more and more and more khair. And wallahi, that is how our life will shape and become. Remember, deen didn't come in one blow. The Quran was not given to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam just like that. Boof. Right? That's why take your time. Allah Ta'ala knows your intention. Allah Ta'ala knows where you're heading. You know, keep that intention and always renew it. You know, inshallah, Ya Rab, this is where I want to get. This is where I'm going to get there. Please, Ya Rab, help me and aid me with this. Who knows? It might not be next Ramadan. Maybe in 2 months' time you realize I can do more. Because what now? Now Allah give barakah in time. 4 months' time I can do more. Allah give more barakah in time. In Ramadan time, you are the guy that you were Ramadan previously. Now you can even work on becoming a better and more extra things that you can do for the sake of Allah Ta'ala. And that's how barakah comes in our life. May Allah bless you all. Have a fantastic and fantabulous life after Ramadan to the next Ramadan. Upkeep that good values that you had. You know, and if you didn't, work now on it. Change now and say, Ya Allah, that what has been said today, it's, you know, it struck hard. In my heart, I want to change. I want to be a changed person. Let me try and strive. Strive now, Allah knows your intention. May Allah allow us many more Ramadans, inshallah. And now, the best action after Ramadan is what? Allah Ta'ala says, the Rasulullah SAW says, whoever follows Ramadan with the 6 days of Shawwal, Allah Ta'ala will give him the reward of fasting an entire year. What's the main word attached to that? Guaranteed. Ramadan, are we guaranteed that our fast has been accepted? We don't know. Allah Ta'ala knows best. But if you fast the 6 days of Shawwal for the sake of Allah, ikhlasan liwajhillah, what will happen? Allah promised us that I will give you a fast of an entire year guaranteed. You didn't even fast a year. But Allah says, guaranteed, my reward for you is as if you have fasted every day. In the year, what's the year? 1445 till 1446. Entire year. Of fast, I will give you, mashallah. May Allah accept that from us. Barakallahu feekum. Allah bless you all. Jazakumullah khairan. Keep us in your du'as, as you will always be in our du'as, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Just a few announcements. And one announcement is Gaza. We don't forget Gaza. Inshallah, 5 o'clock today. Bi'idhnillah. Let us get together, inshallah ta'ala, and we have our placard demonstration. We are never going to forget the people of Gaza. Ameen. Ameen. We will never ever forget the people of Gaza. Ameen, Ya Rab. We will show, inshallah. If we can't, our du'as are with the people that will stand there, inshallah. Most importantly, our du'as are with the people of Gaza. Our du'as are with the people of Palestine. Our du'as are with the people of everyone that's oppressed throughout the entire globe, inshallah ta'ala. Barakallahu feekum, jazakumullah khairan, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد فيا أيها المتقون اتقوا الله اتقوا الله اتقوا الله فإن التقوى ملاك الحسنات. وعليكم بالسنة فإن السنة تهدي إلى الإطاعة ومن أطاع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم التنزيل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنذر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. صدق الله العظيم. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام من صام رمضان وأتبعه ستا من شوال كان كمن صام الدهر. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله الجليل لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. اللهم صل وسلم. صحابة أجمعين. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم التنزيل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وأقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله. اللهم اغفر للعباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبه. رضي الله تعالى عنهم عن كل صحابة أجمعين. الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم. وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم. واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم ولا معهم. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان. اللهم حبب إلينا الإسلام. اللهم حبب إلينا القرآن. وزينوا في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. واجعلنا يا الله من الراشدين. واجعلنا يا الله من المتقين. واجعلنا يا الله من المخلصين. واجعلنا من المجاهدين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم منزل الكتاب سريع الحساب اهزم الأحزاب. اللهم اهزمهم وزلزلهم. اللهم اهزمهم وزلزلهم. اللهم اهزمهم وزلزلهم. اللهم ارزقنا صلاة في المسجد الأقصى وهو حر عزيز برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. قوموا إلى صلاتكم رحمكم الله. أقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قر قامت الصلاة قر قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
قال لا إله إلا الله. سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. استووا واعتدلوا فلا تختلفوا فتختلف قلوبكم. الصلاة رحمكم الله. صلوا صلاة مودع. الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو
عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله العظيم نستغفر الله العظيم نستغفر الله العظيم التواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليك ونسألك توبة ومغفرة وهداية لنا إنه هو التواب الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام وإليك يعود السلام فحينا ربنا بالسلام وأدخلنا الجنة برحمتك دار السلام تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين مقبول إن شاء الله تقبل